Gentleman's game here. Have you ever looked at a cute girl from across the room and just wanted to go up and say hi? But maybe you're just not feeling in the mood or you don't want to look weird and creepy. Wouldn't it be so much easier and convenient if you could somehow get her to come talk to you instead, if it were that effortless? Well, this is the perfect video for you then. Here are 7 ways to get any girl to approach you without you needing to take the initiative to talk to her first. By the way, if you want to learn more about the fundamentals of attraction, check out my free 5-page PDF in the link below. Number 1. FFG. Fashion, fitness, and grooming. Guys love to complain about their looks, but seldom actually put in the effort to improve their looks. There are several ways to make yourself more physically attractive. I call these the big 3. FFG. Fashion, fitness, and grooming. So, learn how to be fashionable. You don't need to go overboard with this, just have clothes that fit you well, and a wardrobe of simple and versatile clothing. I recommend learning how to rock clean fashion staples, like a nice quality white t-shirt, some nice fitting blue jeans, and some white low-cut sneakers. Things like a black leather jacket, blue jean jacket, gray hoodie, black joggers are also some great, universally pretty stylish items that are not too hard on the wallet. Fitness. I always harp on this, but being in shape is probably the single greatest way to become more physically attractive. Go to the gym or learn a workout regimen to do from home. It'll make you more confident in your body, it'll give you a nice chiseled jawline, a more defined core, plus it'll make you feel more energetic, positive, and just healthy. Learn to eat healthier as well and make sure you have a proper amount of veggies and protein and try to cut back on the fat. You know, adjust your calories based on your goals, whether it's to gain more muscle or lose more fat. In terms of grooming, I suggest getting into a skincare routine to keep yourself looking young and vibrant. Also, learn to get a good haircut that fits for your head shape and for the style you want to go for. Nails, nose hair, and such should obviously be trimmed, and I suggest keeping any facial hair neat and clean as well. Number 2. The piercing smile. Whenever I meet a girl I find attractive from across the room, I always do one thing. I'll casually look around the room until my eyes wander over to her, then I'll hold my glance in this direction for a second until I catch her gaze and we make eye contact. Then I give her a grin, almost with a little bit of cockiness, then a head nod. It's very simple, but it's also very powerful from my experience. The reason it's so effective is because guys rarely actually do this. Seriously, girls will tell me all the time how guys will stare at them in the club or wherever they are, but they won't smile. They'll just look at her, take in her beauty, but then looks away when she looks back. Probably because they didn't want to be caught looking at her, or they were too shy or scared to approach her, so they play it off all aloof and whatnot. Trust me, women can feel this nervous energy, and it's very off-putting. Having the confidence to look at our girl from across the room, then hold eye contact, and when she notices you looking, you smile and give a slight head nod, this is very refreshing for most girls. It conveys self-belief, it shows you're someone who knows what he wants and isn't afraid to let that desire be known. And by smiling and head nodding after making eye contact, you're showing that you're coming from a place of fun and good energy and intentions. Some of the best memories I've had were ones where girls would approach me simply by giving them this eye contact, smile, and nod combo. Number 3. Be the social orbiter. Most of you guys know that social proof is one of the most powerful ways to attract a girl. You know, basically, the more social status that a girl sees that you have, the more attractive that she'll find you. Because if she sees that you know a lot of people, and that those people treat you with respect, she'll understand that you're a high-value dude. If you're the guy in the middle of the room, introducing people to each other, saying hi to new people, making them feel welcome, then that is a very attractive trait. Once a girl sees you as the social orbiter in the room, the popular guy, then she'll want to get to know you. She'll want to be a part of your inner circle, since she sees how everyone else enjoys being in your company. And chances are she'll be wondering to herself, man, who is this guy? He seems so cool, and will be introducing herself to you. A good way to be the social orbiter of the room, even if you don't know everyone, is to be a source of positive emotions. Crack jokes here and there, tell some entertaining stories, and connect with people without going overboard or being overbearing. Number 4. Displaying competence. What are you good at? Something that you really care about. Maybe it's jujitsu, maybe it's dance, racing motorcycles, or making tattoo art, or maybe you're just really good at your job. Whatever you're competent in, let that talent be known. Show up to events where people, girls, etc. can see you displaying the skill and competence in your chosen field, whether in a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu tournament, a dance competition, or a tattoo art show. Since she's also at this event, she obviously cares about the art, and if you show that you're among the best in the room at your craft, she'll be curious how you got to the level that you did. Competence is a very attractive trait to have as a man because it proves that you're disciplined, that you don't give up when things are hard or when you get thrown challenges your way. This is actually something I love to combine with tip number two, the eye contact, smile, and nod. As you're showing your competence, give her a smile and nod, and girls will love you for this and will want to approach you. That's because you're first proving that you're a high-value dude by displaying your competence, and then you're indicating to her a bit of interest without being needy. She'll be wondering who you are and will want to get to know you. Number 5. Giving value. This one kind of goes hand in hand with being a social orbiter as well, but you're not just giving value to people in a social setting, you're directly displaying to her your value. So this could mean treating people well, doing acts of kindness for others with no expectation of them to return the favor. When girls see softness from a dude who also has a rough masculine exterior, it makes her melt and want to approach you. Another example of giving value can be treating animals well. For example, I love dogs and take mine walking whenever I can around the city. Girls will approach me all the time to ask questions about the dog or to pet it. They see me treating this pup with love, which a lot of the time makes them want to introduce themselves to me. Using pets or animals in online dating profile pictures like in Tinder or Hinge is also very, very effective. It literally tripled my match rate after I started using pictures of my dog. Giving value can also mean you offering to help her out with something, like carrying something heavy for instance, or offering some advice to some problem. Even though this would technically require you to initiate the conversation by offering help, many times afterwards when you're about to walk away, she'll stop you and then give a proper introduction. In fact, this has happened to me many times. Number 6. Being a leader. Showing leadership skills is one of the most attractive traits a man could have. A man who's confident, empathetic, and an effective leader draws people in, especially girls. Most people tend to fall into one of two categories. The leader, someone who likes to steer the group into a direction, convincing them to join his vision, or the follower, someone who prefers to go with the flow of the group and not stand out too much. If you're in the second category, maybe you're more introverted and aren't really comfortable leading others, that's not something you should be ashamed of. However, it is important to learn some principles of leadership, such as speaking publicly, being decisive, and learning how to handle people, because those attributes will always be appreciated. Girls are innately attracted to leadership, going all the way back to prehistoric times. I mean, think about it, when humanity were all in little tribes of 150 to 200 people, which man tended to have the most children, the most wives? It was almost always the leader of the tribe, the person who could sway the thinking of the group and lay out a good plan on how to go about hunting food and finding shelter, etc. The leader of the tribe had the most power, the most influence, and consequently, the most options with women. In the 21st century, leadership is more relevant than ever. Girls expect you to be able to lead them when you take her out on dates, instead of just asking her, "Where do you want to go next?" Right? They expect you to lead in situations of crisis or high stress. Here are some examples to practice your leadership skills. You can lead a project or task in high school or work. You can organize a study group maybe. You can identify some sort of problem in an organization and then propose a solution to fix it. Volunteering is also a great way to build leadership skills. Training or mentoring another person either in school, work, or some other organization is also leadership. Once you get comfortable with these kind of things and showing more and more leadership qualities, girls will naturally gravitate towards you, and they'll be curious about you. Number 7. The Wave Principle. I remember growing up back in the day, I used to love watching the show Drake and Josh. If you're a 90s kid from the US, there's a good chance you know the show, a Nickelodeon classic. There was one scene from an episode that I'll never forget. Josh, the chubby but well-intentioned brother, decides he wants to meet new girls and start dating more, but he has no idea how. So his mother actually suggests that they go to the movie theater and she teach him a few tricks to get a date. And at first Josh is all like, "I don't know, mom, don't you think that's kind of sad, learning how to talk to girls from your mom?" But then his mother gives him this look like, "Let's be real, Josh, you need all the help you can get." So he decides to let her help. They're at the movies, and his mother points at a cute girl by the counter. "Go talk to her," his mom says. But what do I say? I want you to walk up to her, give her a compliment, then just walk away. Okay, Josh says as he goes up to the girl. Hello. Hi. Those are really cool shoes. Thanks. Later, Josh slowly walks away. Hey, wait up, the girl calls back. You're gonna compliment my shoes, then just walk away? Yeah. Well, you wanna call me sometime? This scene will always stay with me because it taught me as a young kid the power of not putting all your cards on the table, of showing intent but not too much intent, right? It taught me the power of giving her some space to chase you. Learning to apply this principle effectively, you know, of giving a girl a sincere compliment with no strings attached, no neediness, and then walking away to prove that you're not expecting anything back from her will make her chase you. So, those are 7 tips to get girls to approach you. To recap, they are FFG, fashion, fitness, and grooming, the piercing smile, being a social orbiter, displaying competence, giving value, being a leader, and applying the wave principle of giving her attention, then taking it away. If you enjoyed this video, follow me on IG, link in the description below. Next week, I'm going into something very important, 4 tips that I have for dudes in their 20s. So make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. And as always, peace.